I think to really understand what the Slenderman phenomena is, you need to go right back to the very beginning. German artist Hans Holbein, and this is widely considered to be the first documented encounter with this phenomena. In this carving we see somebody battling what's clearly a non-human entity. Since that time, sightings and encounters with this phenomena have increased hugely, and this is probably due to the fact that technology has provided an avenue to document this with cameras and so forth. We've found examples of this phenomena in family photographs and indeed other photographs going right back to the 1920s, and this trend has continued exponentially since then. When we review all of the cases that we have collected, whether it be cases here in this country, in Ireland, which seem to be increasing also, or various cases from other countries, we see a pattern emerging. Disturbingly, the pattern seems to center around missing people. Shortly after documented encounters with this phenomena, we find that usually, and sadly, children disappear. This photograph is a typical example of what we see. We see in the background a large figure, humanoid, although not really human. Tall, quite tall, maybe 8 to 10 foot, with sort of tendrils or long outstretched arms, sometimes not two arms, perhaps four arms, and near children. And this particular photograph that was taken in the United States, several of the children in the photograph were reported missing shortly afterwards. And there doesn't seem to be any explanation for that. Ireland itself is full of stories and myths of things of the paranormal and an unusual nature. What's interesting is that there's a similarity between this phenomena and things that already exist in our folklore culture. For example, in Ireland in the past we had what were known as changelings, where children were taken away by fairies and replaced by changelings. This bears some resemblance to what we've seen happen with this phenomena. I first became aware of this phenomena approximately 5 years ago. A friend of mine, a now retired police sergeant, Paul Campbell, was walking through the woods and encountered something he hadn't seen before and that he couldn't explain. So it was this area up here, this trail that runs along here through the wood. Mr. Campbell had been out for a walk that evening and he He walked up in this direction. This is the spot here. We've actually left a marker in the ground. This is approximately where Mr. Campbell said he saw the entity or the Slender Man. And we've actually had soil samples taken from the ground here, and they've been sent to the lab. This will help us hopefully determine if something did indeed happen here. In the last 5 years alone, I've documented well over 300 cases. The similarity between the photographs is what's most interesting. We see the same shape, or at least very similar shape, in every photograph. The official explanations on a lot of these photographs are unusual. There's no camera error, there's no digital anomalies causing a problem. What you see is what you get. These are real images and real things that are appearing. Adults that come into contact with this being, the Slender Man, also seem to suffer side effects, extreme paranoia, physical illness such as nausea, vomiting, things of that sort. And in some cases, as I've seen firsthand, we have a situation where the person becomes so mentally impaired by the encounter that unfortunately they no longer can function in society and have to be remanded into care. What the lab found from the soil samples was that the soil content in that area compared to samples taken relatively close by varied dramatically. The soil samples that we took were completely sterile, totally 100% sterile compared to neighboring areas where the soil wasn't. This suggests that the soil somehow was affected. At the end of the day, we're left with more questions than answers. What is the Slender Man? Why do children seem to disappear? Is he a force for good or bad? Is he a being that has been with us longer than history can record? We have countless numbers of sightings from around the globe now, with photographic evidence to back them up, and some very credible witnesses corroborating these events. All we can do is keep looking for answers. I myself have not encountered this being, and from what I've seen and heard, I can't say I want to.